We have def for giving names to values and fun for giving names to functions. What if I want to give a name to this type, list of string? I would like to call it groceries, for example. I can say groceries equals list of string as long as I put the keyword type in front of it. And so that makes groceries a shorthand for a list of string. That's one easy way to define types, but it's a fairly limited way because we already have to have the right kind of type existing. Suppose that I want to talk about animals, where animals are either tigers and snakes. So to do that, I can't just put an equal sign because I have this or. Instead, with type, I use vertical bars like we do when we have different possibilities. So I will write tiger and snake as different possibilities, but I'm not yet done because after each kind of animal, I need to say what kinds of fields it has. So for tigers, it turns out I care about what color they are, and I'll use a symbol for that. And I care about how many stripes they have. So I will use an integer for that. For snakes, I also care about the color, but a snake, I care about its weight, let's say, and its favorite food that I'll use a string for. So that is the full syntax of defining animal. When I run this, a number of names have been defined. The type animal is defined, but also the variant names tiger and snake are defined. And they're defined as functions that I can call to make a tiger or make a snake. That is, if I say tiger that is orange with 1 plus 2 stripes, then I get back a tiger orange 3. Of course, the 1 plus 2 got evaluated to 3. And you can see that its type is animal. Note that its type is not tiger because tiger is not a type. Tiger is just one possibility for an animal type. Instead of a tiger, I could make a snake, which is green, weighs 10 somethings, and likes to eat rats. So again, I get an animal back, snake. If I give it the wrong number of arguments or the wrong kind of arguments in these constructions, of course it would complain. The advantage now is that I can write a function like animal color that takes an animal. And I'm going to give back the symbol for its color. Now, how do I do that? Somehow inside of here, I need to decide whether I have a tiger or a snake. And then I need to get the color out of a tiger or the color out of a snake. So in this language, what we could do is use a conditional and say that A is a tiger, then I will do something. Otherwise, A is a snake. And I will do something else. And what do I do in the case of a tiger? Then I can use the function tiger.color that is defined up here by the fact that I said tiger has a field color and use that on A, or I can use snake.color and use that on A. Now it happens that I have color in both of these. In general, that's not always the case, and there is no animal color or anything like that. There's only variant name dot each of the field names. So I have to decide whether I have an animal that's a tiger or a snake, and then I could get the animal color of a tiger that is orange. Of course, I expect to get orange back. And when I run this, I do.